In this video lecture, I am going to discuss about the soldering and brazing. So, oxyhydrogen welding, which I covered it in the previous video lecture. In this, I am going to talk about soldering, then about the brazing. Then comparison between brazing, soldering and the welding process. So already we know that the joining process is divided into fastening, welding and adhesive bonding. Further, welding is divided into fusion, solid state resistance and other methods. So in other methods we have classified it as soldering and brazing. In this video we try to understand there are certain requirements are there where we welding doesn't work out. So in such cases the soldering and brazing processes are used. This is what we are going to study in soldering. Any process, whether welding, soldering or brazing, we have to study it, all the things in this particular fashion. That is, first we should know the principle of working, then what equipments are there, what are the varieties of that, varieties are there, what are the applications of that, and what are the advantages and disadvantages. So this pattern remains same for the welding, soldering and the brazing. So let's try to understand what do you mean by the soldering process or the principle behind the soldering process. The American Welding Society defines the soldering as a joining process which takes place below the 450 degrees centigrade. So joining process by soldering is a method. So where we are going to join similar as well as dissimilar metals also. The important point in the soldering is that the metal parts being joined are heated but not melted. Whereas in case of welding, we heat it up to the melting point of the edges of the joints. Another important point is here, the filler material is in the form of molten metal. And this molten form of the filler metal is going to be what you call put at the place where we wanted to have the joints, and the filler material will get between the joints with what we call it as a capillary action. So the material which is used as a filler material, we call it as a solder. Basically it is an alloy of lead and tin. But as you know that one, the lead is not good for the environment. So people have started going for the alternatives of the what you call soldering material apart from the lead. So that leads to the what you call use of antimony, bismuth, brass, copper, indium, tin and the silver for the soldering purposes. So along with the filler material, we use flux also in case of soldering machine, soldering process. So commonly used flux is the zinc chloride or the aluminium chloride. So we have to apply this flux. Already we know what is the function of the flux. Basically it protects the joints from the impurities. There are two varieties of solders are there. One we call it as a soft soldering and second one we call it as a hard soldering. This categorization is based on the temperature itself. Anything less than 450 is called, we call it as a soft soldering. Anything more than it is called as a what you call a hard soldering. So soft and hard soldering are the two varieties of the soldering processes. So normally this hard soldering is also called as a brazing. Okay, the ability of joining solders is dependent on the how much better it will melt the joining parts. If the wettability is more, then we are going to get the good joint between the materials. So these are the what you call points which are important for the soldering process. Here is a list of equipment used for the soldering. Soldering gun is there, wire cutter is there, tweezers are there, soldering tools for the desoldering is there, soldering stand is there, wet spond is there, and solder flux is there. These are all related with what you call the soldering process, which is we carry out for the electronic one. Not necessary that soldering is only restricted to the electronic one. It is even in mechanical industry also we use the soldering. So here is the different steps of a soldering process. The very first step of the soldering process is that cleaning of the joining surfaces. It is essential there should not be any impurity or dirt on the joining edges. The second one is application of the flux. We apply the flux over the joint. Then the third step is what we call it as a tinning. That is nothing but what you call keeping the tip of the solder iron clean from the impurities. So this is done by just heating it and what you call immersing in the flux. So in this way, so we keep that tip of the solder iron clean so that it can heat the joining parts quickly. Otherwise, you are not going to get the sound soldering joints. So this process of cleaning, we call it as a tinning of the surfaces. Next is heating. So as we already told, we are going to heat the parts to be joined, but we are not heating to the what you call melting temperature or the molten state. Just we heat it and we supply the filler material, which we call it as a solder one. So once we heating takes place, then filler material is placed along with the soldering gun. Then because of the capillary action, the molten metal will suck into the joints and there will be a permanent joint between the two pieces. The finally is the cleaning process. These are the different methods of soldering. So already we discussed the soldering iron, torch method, wave method, resistance method, and induction method. Remember, all these categorization is based on the way we heat it. So if you are using soldering iron, it will be a soldering iron. If you use the torch, then it's called as by the same name. If you use the resistance heating, then it is called as a resistance soldering method. If you go for the induction, it is also called as a induction. It is quite similar that one. For cooking, we use the different methods. We may cook it on gas, we may cook it on induction, we can cook it on microwave. So these are all nothing but a categorization which we make on the based on the way we heat it. So here is again the list of what you call different soldering methods. So particular diagram here, it will show that what you call soldering gun, the next one is the torch is there, third one is the wave soldering is there. As far as soldering with the gun is there, already you are all familiar with that one. So we use the gun, so we use the flux and solder. So we heat the gun with using the electricity. Once it is heated up, so the joints to be joined are heated and filler material is filled there, and the joining between the two things will take place. In case of torch method, the heating is made with the help of a torch. So normally, if you look at the what you call the silver chains, what normally people or the woman wear it in the as a ankle bracelets. So those chains are normally what you call soldered with the torch method. So we are using the earlier kerosene torch were there. Nowadays gas torches are there. So we apply the heat with the help of torch. The then we keep on putting the little quantity of the filler metal at the all the small points of the chain where we wanted to solder it. So the one more method is very popular, that is what we call it as a wave soldering. This is related with the soldering of the electronic equipments. Any electronic equipment you talk about, it consists of a printed circuit board over which we are going to put several transistors and other electronic items, and at the bottom we are going to join them or we are going to solder it. Because these are arranged in a particular order, that is what we call it as a circuit. So here is a very simple method is there. So the green one will show you the what you call printed circuit board. On top of that you can see that resistors are there. So we do the little preheating. So then we apply the flux there. So we apply the flux, then we do little preheating. Then we will pass that printed circuit board over the soldering bath. So where solder is heated to the molten state, and it is arrangement is made such that one, the bath will move upwards so that it will touch the strands of the your transistor or the resistance. So in this way, in a single stroke, we can carry out the soldering process, because we know that one. So electronic circuit boards have several points where we need to solder it. Next is brazing. Brazing is quite similar to the soldering. The only difference is that one, the temperature is more than the soldering temperature. And there is one more difference is there, that is the filler material. So there, in case of soldering, it was lead and tin. In case of brazing, it is the copper alloys or the silver alloys. So normally copper zinc alloy is used, usually what we call it as a brass. So we use the brass for as a filler material for the brazing one. Even if you look at this diagram, it will show you that one, the way we create the joint using the brazing process is slightly different from the soldering process. So that's why the brazing processes are used for repair of the structural items or tubes, pipes, cylinders. So again, they also come under the structure category itself. So the filler material is called by a special name, what we call it as a spelter. So we use borax as a flux material for brazing process. Again, the basic steps are remain same, that is cleaning, then application of the flux, then heating. Okay, so here are the varieties of brazing. So torch brazing is there, furnace bearing is there, braze welding is there, and dip brazing is there. So in case of torch brazing, so we are using a torch to heat the joining materials. Okay, so that's why it is called as a torch brazing, and we put the filler material once the preheating of the joints takes place. So if the same heating, if it takes place in a furnace, then we call it as a furnace brazing. So this is advised when we have small and large number of components are there, they are to be brazed one, then we can go for the what you call furnace. Small pieces are put together and the filler material is poured, or it will be kept along the joints where we wanted to get the joints. Then a whole bunch is set into the, it sent into the furnace. For the pre-required time, it will be heated up and the brazing will take place. The braze welding is quite similar to the welding process itself. So normally we use bronze here as a filler material. Brass is alloy of copper and zinc. If you take the copper and the tin, then it will become what we call it as a bronze. Bronze is little more stronger than the brass material. So next is what you call dip brazing. There are small joints are there where we need to braze the component. Under that situation, so we go for the dip brazing. So you can see in the picture that one, two items are there which has to be brazed. Similarly, we will be having different tanks there. So we will dip it. One will be belong to the flux. So we apply the flux on the joints to be made. Then we are going to dip this pieces into the molten bath of the soldering. And remember, it is also been protected by the flux so that no impurity will add to it. So these are the different types of what you call brazing processes. The finally look at the advantages of soldering and brazing process. The biggest advantage is the low temperature. So because of the low temperature, the properties of the base metal is not going to change. That is the advantage of soldering and brazing. So joints can be made between similar and dissimilar metals. And remember, so we can go for a permanent joints or the temporary joints. Both we can have it. So if you apply little heat, so we can dismantle the soldering joint or the brazing joint. If you don't do that one, so it will be a permanent joint. So speed of joining is also very high in case of brazing and the soldering. So next is, there is a less chance of damaging the parts because the heat involved is quite low when compared to the welding one. So parts of various thicknesses we can join it. If we wanted to join the thin thicknesses, welding can't do it. So whereas soldering and brazing, we can use it for the thin as well as thick one. Preferably we go for the thin. Thick one, again, it will be what you call using the welding process we do it. So these are the some disadvantages. Large section cannot be joined. Flux may contain some toxic element. Soldering joint cannot be used in high temperature applications. And they are having the low strength of joints. Finally, the comparison we are going to do between the welding, soldering and brazing. The criteria on which I am going to talk, consider is the first temperature. In case of welding 4000 to 5000, soldering below 450, brazing above 450. Strength, strongest one, welding, soldering, weakest one, brazing in between. Filler material, it is a similar type of the material as that of base metal. In soldering, it is solder. In case of brazing, it is speltler. The type of the metals to be joined, similar metals we try to join it in welding. In soldering also, most of the time we use it for the similar material. So whereas brazing can be used for joining similar as well as dissimilar metals. Finally, the flux. In case of welding, we use carbonate and silicate material. In soldering, we use it as a rosin. And in case of brazing, it is borax. So thank you for listening my vertical lecturer. Remember, education is not the learning of the facts, but training of the mind to think. So do remember whatever you learned in this video and repeat it and try to adopt in your thinking process. Thank you.